Hello everybody, welcome back to the Standards for TB Care in India. Standard 10 addresses TB patients having HIV infection. Here the treatment of tuberculosis in people living with HIV is the same as in those who do not have an HIV infection. The regimen is the same and the duration of treatment is the same. ART, that is antiretroviral therapy, has to be started irrespective of the CD4 cell count in these patients, and this should be done as early as possible, preferably within the first 8 weeks following initiation of antituberculous treatment. Cotrimoxazole prophylactic therapy is given to prevent other opportunistic infections, and isoniazid preventive therapy for 6 months or longer is given after ruling out active tuberculosis. Standard 11 deals with the important topic of treatment adherence. Here, adherence has to be patient-centered. That is, it should be based on the patient's need, with mutual respect being maintained between both the patient and the provider. And all measures of treatment adherence, that is, whichever drug is given, it should be individualized supervision, and all support should be individualized. Where possible, we should identify and appoint a treatment supporter for monitoring the treatment adherence. And the treatment supporter that we identify, he should be accessible and accountable both to the patient and to the healthcare system. Finally, we should use information technology wherever possible and use it in an optimal fashion to promote both treatment literacy and adherence. Standard 12 talks about public health responsibility. Now, any practitioner who's treating TB should realize that he assumes a public health responsibility to prevent both ongoing transmission of infection as well as the development of drug resistance. And to fulfill this, the practitioner must prescribe an appropriate regimen, and he must also utilize public health services, community services and other agencies including NGOs to ensure that adherence is maintained by the patient. Standard 13 deals with the notification of TB cases. All health establishments must report all TB cases and the treatment outcomes to public health authorities. Here we have a district nodal officer for notification who is present, to whom we can notify. And if I show the contribution of the private sector to notification, it is only 19%, and this leaves a lot to be desired, but nevertheless it has improved over the preceding years. Now, on the part of the health system, the health system has to ensure that the feedback is given to the healthcare provider about the outcome of the referred patients. Standard 14 talks about maintaining records for all TB patients, and a record has to be maintained, a written record has to be maintained for all patients with respect to the medication given, to the bacteriological response, with respect to adverse reactions and clinical outcome. Standard 15 deals with contact investigation. We know that they form a high risk group. So, we have to ensure that all household contacts and other persons who are in close contact with TB patients are screened for tuberculosis, and also that reverse contact tracing is done in cases of pediatric TB patients. Standard 16 is on isoniazid prophylactic therapy. This is given to children less than 6 years of age who are close contacts of TB patients, after excluding active tuberculosis. These children are treated with isoniazid for a minimum period of 6 months, and they are closely monitored for TB symptoms. Standard 17 deals with airborne infection control. This is an important component of in interruption of transmission, and airborne infection control should be an integral part of all healthcare facilities. Standard 18 is on quality assurance systems. This applies to both diagnostic tests as well as the quality of drugs supplied. So, all healthcare providers should ensure that TB diagnostic tests which they are used for diagnosis are quality assured, and that anti-TB drugs, this is a directive given to the health system, that quality assurance systems should ensure that anti-TB drugs used in the country are subject to stringent quality assurance mechanisms at all levels. Standard 19 talks about Panchayati Raj Institutions and elective representatives as having an important role to share in the public health responsibility for TB control. Standard 20 deals with health education, where every TB symptomatic should be properly counseled by healthcare providers, and TB patients and their family members should get proper counseling and healthcare education at every contact with the healthcare system. Standard 21 is about the death audit among TB patients, and this death audit should be done by a competent authority. Standard 22 is on the information which has to be imparted regarding TB prevention and care seeking. So, all individuals, especially women, the children, the differently abled and other vulnerable groups, those who are at increased risk, they should all receive information related to TB prevention and care seeking. Standard 23 talks about free and quality services. It is a direction given to the healthcare system that all patients, especially those in the vulnerable groups, are to be offered free or affordable quality assured diagnostic services as well as treatment services, and these should be provided at locations and times to minimize work or school disruptions and to maximize access. Okay, standard 24 talks about the respect, confidentiality and the sensitivity of the patient, and says that all patients seeking or receiving care for tuberculosis should be received with dignity, managed with promptness, confidentiality and gender sensitivity. And we have to also ensure that the infection control procedures that we advocate to the patients, they do not stigmatize the patients. Standard 25 deals with the care and support through social welfare programs. What the social welfare support systems should attempt is that they should mitigate the out-of-pocket expenses which are incurred by the patient when they are approaching both for diagnosis as well as treatment. And the final standard addresses counseling and other needs of the patient. So, persons affected by TB should be counseled at every opportunity to address information gaps and to enable informed decision making. The counseling should address treatment adherence, adverse drug reaction, prognosis, and physical, financial, psychosocial, and nutritional needs of the patient. So, that brings us to end of all the standards. To summarize, the standards for TB care in India includes standards for TB diagnosis, treatment, prevention, patient care support systems and community engagement. STCI has to be adhered to by both public and private healthcare providers to ensure universal access to quality TB care, and by following this, we can achieve our goal to end tuberculosis. Thank you for your attention.